Minecraft Snapshot 23w32a upgrades to data pack version 17 with changes to effect data formats and loot tables. My name is Sly Slime and I'm here to show you all the changes. Let's start with a command fix though. A bug has been fixed that made messages appear out of order when mixing say commands with other commands like tellraw. In data format changes, effects are now stored differently. The big change here is that the ID of an effect is now a namespaced string instead of an integer, so for instance you'll need to use Minecraft colon mining fatigue instead of 4. The mapping of all the numeric IDs to the new namespaced IDs are on screen now. In addition, fields that store data about effects have been changed to use the standard snake case format. This applies to the effect instances themselves, wherever they appear, with all the fields now lowercase and using underscore for spacing. Items that have effects including all types of potions and tipped arrows now have custom potion effects in that format as well, and suspicious stew items now have effects in lowercase, and the sub-items changed from effect ID and effect duration to just ID and duration. Mushrooms have been changed to have stew effects instead of effect ID and effect duration. The new field is a list of effects just like for suspicious stew items. Area effect clouds now has a lowercase effects field, which is a list of effect instances. Arrows now have a snake case format custom potion effects, which is also a list of effect instances. Players, armor stands, and all types of living entity data now has a snake case active effects field, which is also a list of effect instances. And finally, for block entities, the beacon block entity primary and secondary fields have been renamed primary effect and secondary effect in snake case, and its contents is now a namespaced ID instead of a number. In loot table news, there is a new function called sequence. This allows you to run a sequence of loot functions. It has one field called functions, and that is a list of sub-functions. You can also implicitly specify a sequence by simply inlining a list of functions on the top level. The same thing can now also be done for predicates. Inlining a list of predicates now works exactly as if you had specified an all of predicate. And that's it for Data Pack version 17. My name is Sly Slime, thank you for watching, I'll see you next time!